auto power versus auto power PSD, Pete. Why would I choose one or the other?
Because you like even more confusing units, dividing something by hertz.
Right. I need my colleagues to think I'm really smart, so I'm going to work with the most complicated unit. So I'm going to have this divide by hertz thing, right?
Well, I thought you said something like it's good for random data, but I wasn't quite sure what that meant.
Yes, that's exactly right. So in order to explain this, why I might choose one or the other, we're going to go through a little example. And the big difference here, you see I'm comparing an auto power on the left of this chart versus an auto power PSD on the right of this chart. And then the top row here is for random signals. The bottom is for periodic or sinusoid-based signals. Okay, and you see we get different answers depending on which format we choose for these two cases. In the happenstance or in the event that our frequency resolution might change from one test to another. Okay, so when I'm changing the frequency resolution between tests, I get these results as shown in this table. And we're going to walk through these one at a time to help explain it. Okay?
Okay.
So first we're going to look at a random signal and an auto power. So either auto power, power, or linear, but the levels come out as different. So come with me, if you will, to the local bowling alley. And we have two tables. Okay, table A and table B. And each table decides they're going to go up to the snack bar and they're going to get a pitcher of, in this case, it looks like grape Kool-Aid. But they each are going to get a pitcher, and these pitchers are identical. Okay. However, at table A, there are four people, and at table B, there are eight people. Okay. And they each have the same pitcher to share. So which table will be happier?
What's in the grape Kool-Aid?
Bunch of sugar.
If you like grape Kool-Aid, table A will be happier because each person will get more.
That's right. We're going to take that pitcher of energy and we're going to divide it among four people versus eight people, right? And so table A is going to be happier because they all paid money for this pitcher of Kool-Aid and they're going to get more than their table B counterparts. So the pitcher contents get spread over the number of glasses regardless of how many glasses there are, right? So if there are four glasses available, we're going to split it up four ways. If there are eight glasses available, we split it up eight ways. And in the case of eight glasses, each glass has to get less energy, or in this case, less Purple Source Rex Kool-Aid.
It's kind of like a random signal. It gets distributed sort of evenly
over all of them. Yep, that's exactly right. So a random signal distributes that energy over all available spectral lines, okay? So the more frequency lines or the finer resolution, you will get a lower amplitude, okay? So I've got an 8 hertz random signal in all of these cases, and I've got a delta F of 1 hertz, delta F of 2 hertz, and a delta F of 4 hertz. The picture is going to get spread across all the glasses in each case. If I have a coarser frequency resolution, 4 hertz resolution, it looks like I have more amplitude when I really don't. All of the pitchers started out the same.
And in this world of spectrums, there's no like leaking, like in the 4 hertz case, you don't pour out in between the glasses. Everything gets captured in these glasses.
That's 100% right.
No grape Kool-Aid is wasted.
That's right.
Okay,
so that we get these levels are different with a random signal using an auto power. We're going to take a look now if we did a PSD in these cases instead. So remember, the PSD takes the auto power and it divides it by the frequency resolution, right? That's what the PSD is. And so in each of these cases, we're going to divide by the amplitudes by 1. Here, we're going to divide the amplitudes by 2. So these will get cut in half.
Because they're 2 hertz apart.
Yep. Here, the delta F is 4. So we divide each of these amplitudes by 4. And boom, we end up with identical amplitudes, regardless of a change in frequency resolution with the PSD. Okay.
Maybe so I don't have to measure only with the 1 hertz delta F if I use PSD.
That's right. With a random signal. That is 100% right. Okay. Let's see how things change, though, if we move to a periodic signal. How is a periodic signal different? Well,
this would be like almost like a sinusoid, like at a discrete frequency or something.
Yeah. Indeed, okay. Like 4 hertz. Instead of being all frequencies in this picture, we just have 4 hertz in this picture. We have a single sine wave in each. And so in this case, we don't care if there is a number of different glasses available, because the periodic sine wave, 4 hertz, is only going to be going to the 4 hertz spectral line in each of these cases, right? There's only one frequency here, so it only uses one of the glasses, and so they all end up identical.
So whoever's at the party with the 4 hertz cup, they're happy, and everyone else is sad.
Yeah, exactly. For a sinusoidal signal, that's right. Now, PSD is going to come along and screw this up for us, though, because, again, we're going to divide by the spectral resolution. So this 1 hertz delta F guy, he gets divided by 1. He gets to keep all his Kool-Aid. Delta F equals 2. We're going to divide this amplitude by 2. Okay, so we've just introduced an error. And then this delta F of 4 hertz, we're going to divide by 4, and we're going to introduce an amplitude error. Okay. So PSDs can screw up your amplitude if you have mostly a sinusoidal signal. Okay.
So like if I have a something that's generating discrete tones, I'm probably better off not with the PSD. But if I have something that creates broadband random, then I want the PSD.
That's right. And in the real world, you really likely have a combination of both of those, right? And so I'm going to show you those scenarios. So you see I've got a mix here of broadband noise shown by this sort of, you know, flat lines in the frequency domain, but then I've got these big frequency components that stick up. So I've mixed tones and background noise. And in this case, I'm doing auto powers, and over here I'm going to look at the same signals but calculated with a PSD. I'm going to zoom in here on this peak, and you see all of the broadband amplitudes, if I go off the peak, these are all quite different by 5 or 6 dB, depending on which frequency line I'm at. But you see three different values, right? But if I go right to this peak, boom, now the peaks are a lot closer together in terms of amplitude. So if I go to the global maximum, you see, boom, right at the peak, they are less than 0.1 dB different in terms of amplitude, okay?
And so this is a regular auto power, not the PSD.
That's correct. This is an auto power, so it's screwing up the amplitude of the broadband part of the signal, but getting the tonal or the sinusoidal part perfectly right.
I see.
Now, if I go to do a PSD to fix these broadband signal parts, let's zoom in again. So now we see the broadband random portions of our signal are all lying on top of each other. But now what have I done to my sinusoidal component? I've screwed it up by dividing by the delta F. And now my peak amplitudes and my sine wave components are now introduced that 6 dB different.
So okay. It's Pascal squared per hertz. The random is very similar because you're at PSD, but the sinusoid's all screwed up. Got it.
Got it. So now let's look at our good friend, the vacuums, right? We use these vacuum recordings all the time where it looks like we have some sinusoid part of the signal mixed apart, with some broadband. However, in a real world signal, it looked like a tone, you know, when we were zoomed way out. But when I zoom in on this guy, that spectral line, that tone that vacuum makes moves around enough that my auto power is still going to have a significant amplitude difference on these tonal-like components. And I'm better off, even with a real-world signal, using the PSD, because you see this isn't really a true sinusoid. It's moving around enough in real life to spread that energy out, and the PSD captures the amplitude much more accurately. Okay?
And go back to the auto powers, where they looked very different. I was kind of curious. I know you can do this double X cursor and calculate an RMS.
Yeah, I sure can.
Okay, so this, even though visually they look different, the signal, the energy in the signal is the same, huh?
Yeah, the energy is still there. It just doesn't get distributed all to one frequency. It's spread across all of the spectral lines. And so by summing them all up, I get that energy back.
Good trick is to do that double X cursor with a sum. Okay, thanks.
Yeah.